It's a Sunday afternoon, just come down to catch the sunset, which is it's quite bright behind me. Obviously the camera's compensated for my ugly face. But I'm going to be doing a bit of sketching with casein paints in my Seawhite sketchbook, and just try and catch this sun as it's going down, so it'll be a very quick sketch. And let's see how we get on. That's the setup for today. A couple of old pencil cases I use for palettes. I keep this one for whites and greys. A couple of mucky ones there for the other colours. I'll probably just use it like a Zorn palette today. Yellow ochre, red, black, and the white. I've got the blue just in case. That's my water container. Just a few brushes, small short-handled ones. And I've got my box in case I need to do any drawing. And this is the paper we're using, the Seawhite. Quite thin paper, but I quite like that, smooth. And right, we best get moving.
Start by laying in a wash of colour, and based on what I'm looking at in the sky, so it's like an orange, pink and some greys. This is just a quick watered down wash of the casein paint. It just gives me something to work with. You can see there from that picture there, my stool sank right into the soft sand. That's not because of my weight, it's because of the softness of the sand. You can see it there, my feet are lovely soft sand. I'm just laying some greys over the sky there, just to show where the cloud was. There's like a bank of cloud, and that's what basically what blocked out the sun and stopped it from giving us a dramatic sunset. But it was still quite nice and sort of soft, subtle colours that reflected into the sea. And I quite like those mucky palettes, because it means I can use some of the colours that are already in there to make these greys. And as the casein dries so fast, a lot of the, it looks like it's a messy palette which would muck up all my colours, but actually the casein is so dry on there, it doesn't really pick up a lot, so I can mix on top of it without picking it up too much. Basil enjoying the view. And there's Godrevy lighthouse over there. So the casein dries so fast, the paper's quite damp, but I can paint right into it. And it's sort of drying at a nice pace, so I can lay over colours over the top. You see how wet that paint is there, and that sort of the paper stays damp, but it's not too wet. It's not like a watercolour. This is quite opaque paint, so you can paint over the top, and I actually prefer it to than watercolour, to be honest. It just suits my way of painting more. I've always liked opaque paints. I suppose that's why I quite like the work of Stuart Shills, an American artist who does a lot of work with mainly opaque paints. No, what I was after here, it was just an impression of this scene. So you see I'm quickly brushing on areas to represent some of these waves, not paying too much attention to the details. Obviously the sun's going down, as you can see there, it's, the light's going, so I can't sort of stop to sort of take a photo and paint it from that. I'm just painting from what I see, and obviously I've got to be quite quick, because this was about 20 minutes, 25 minutes. constantly laying new layers of colour over the top of what I've already painted, and that's the advantages casein has, because it's already dried quite nicely. When it's opaque, I can cover it, it's got great coverage. Amazing how Basil just enjoying that, watching the sunset with us. Just trying to put a few details in where the waves are breaking, the tiny small waves there. I just needed to sort of hint at them. Somebody beachcombing.
Quite interesting that these areas are they change from the pinky red there, and they go sort of this bluey grey over here then.
Quite nice. Yeah, I quite like that sort of blue violety grey on that side, that right hand side there. I suppose it was reflecting the cloud a bit more, and on the other side you've got the pinkness of the sky coming through, peachy colour. And the dark area there to the left, that's just a bit of dark sand that I could see. Again, back into the water to add some more colours from the sky in there. This is a good exercise in just rapid painting to try and record a changing scene. And it's good in a way because it's a very lightweight setup to carry around. I haven't got to carry too much, no easel, nothing like that. This is my basic sketching setup, which I carry around most mornings when I take the dog for a walk. Usually either got to these casein paints or my oil sticks, charcoal. Usually mix it up, taking the casein or any paints we use, the water-based paints is great as long as you remember to take your water. Just putting a few of those waves just breaking and into the mid-ground there, and painting those in a bit softer. Just softening the sky there, some greys, and then same in the water. This is where the waves are breaking here, which is a curious colour because it was quite, you know, it's quite white, but because it was on the other side of the where the lights, so basically it was in the shadow area, it was very difficult to represent with the colours I had. Found that quite tricky, just those limited colours.
It's weird, I can't see any engines, any boats, nothing out there.
Yeah, we could hear an engine, but we couldn't see anything out at sea. Sounded like a boat quite close into the shore, but couldn't actually see anything. And that's happened before there.
Right, so we've been here for about probably 20 minutes, 25 minutes now, and the sun never really set in the way I was hoping. So that's what we made of it today. Casein paint, so it's just water based, and just used a ivory black, yellow ochre, cadmium red, and the titanium white. And it's from Godrevy Beach. We're on the 17th of October 2021, sunset from Godrevy. There we go. Okay, there's my little sketch. Casein on paper, Godrevy Beach, 17th of October, Sunday afternoon, end of the afternoon, early evening. Not too cold, where we are quite sheltered. And as usual, thanks for watching, and bye for now.